You can't please. A past there will be some chain of events, some things that will happen to you in your life that is not meant to be altered, changed, or understood. These are the things that have been designed and orchestrated by God to test our faith, perfect our character, bring us to spiritual maturity, cause us to grow in the knowledge of God, and to teach us how to sow the lead. And the people on here, can I get you to lean on a neighbor and help me say, neighbor, I know you don't understand it. I know it don't make no sense. I know you can't wrap your mind around it, but it was in God's plan. Tell them, I know it don't look good, but the fact that you didn't die, the fact that it didn't kill you, the fact that it didn't destroy you, the fact that you survived it, is an indication that God is at work in your life. And you may not understand everything God is doing, but whatever God is doing in this next season, will you lean on somebody and tell him he ain't doing it without me? As a matter of fact, turn around and tell three people what God is about to do in this next season. Somebody ought to praise God right there. Somebody shout, he ain't doing it without me. And Bishop Porter, Pastor, I made up my mind that in this next season of my life, I'm giving my haters two choices. You gonna either be a greater hater or a celebrator. Because what God is doing in this next season, somebody shout, he included me. Psalms 81. Psalms 89. Let us know. Give me a flat and I'll get out of here. That the name of the Lord is excellent in all of us. Isaiah 55 and 8 tells us that God's thoughts are not our thoughts, neither is his ways our way, but as high as the heavens are above the earth, so are God's thoughts above our thoughts. Who can know the mind?